Hello children, how are you? Hope all are fine at home. I am really very happy to see you back again in Max class as a Max teacher. I welcome you all to this Max class with this bouquet of beautiful flowers. I feel like you people are all buds like this colorful flowers. You are all going to bloom in different ways with different colors. I wish you all the best to have a colorful class 8. Okay, children. Today let us begin our session with a thought so that we will keep it up till the end. Sometimes later becomes never. So do it now. I want each and every one of you, and I wish every one of you should follow it up. Don't heap up the work. Keep doing every day and you can have a wonderful success. Okay, my dear children, in previous classes you have learnt about data handling. Let us continue with the data handling in a new chapter as introduction to graphs. Hope you are all familiar with all these diagrams. What are they? Very good. Hope you are all answering me. Bar graphs, double bar graph. Okay. Say now, come on. Tell me what is graph. Every time I used to ask you definition. How will you define a graph? Very good. I can say graph as visual representation of data collected. We used to represent data. And graph is one of the tool to visualize the data. If it is a raw data, everyone will not be able to understand. Only literate people will be able to understand. These graphs will give a clear idea about the data even for illiterates. That's why graphs plays a very big role in every field. Okay. Now, how many types of graphs you already know? First thing you will say it as bar graph. Okay. Bar graph is used to show comparison among categories. Different categories will be there, and this tool is used to compare the categories. Okay. Can I use this bar graph to represent a whole single idea? No, I cannot use it. In such cases, okay, let me give an example. How you spend your holidays, whole holiday. Okay, it's a whole. Or I can say it, how will you spend 24 hours of a day, that whole. And I want how much you spend in each and every activity. Of course, I can represent even this in bar graph, but it will be better and it will be understandable easily if I go in for pie charts. Okay. Hope you know what is the other name of pie chart. Very good, my dear children. It is a circle graph. First we saw about bar graph. It is circle graph. So pie chart is used to compare parts of a whole. Okay, there it is used to compare among different categories. Here it is used to compare parts of a whole. Okay, this can also be represented using bar graph. Now, histogram. This histogram you did in class 8, now in previous classes, it resembles bar graph. Am I right, my dear children? Yes. How is histogram different from bar graph? Just by viewing at it, you will immediately say bar graphs have equal space. There is a space between each and every bar. See here, there is a space. After this bar, I have a space. But in histogram, do I have? No. They are continuous. There is no space between bars. Now, next difference, what do you feel? Here also I have number of girls in class. Here too I have number of students. But when I come to x-axis, here I have categories. Category class 6, class 7, class 8. Whereas here I will not have categories. Even that categories will have numerical value. And this will frame an interval from 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15. These are grouped data. Hope you are able to understand. So it is going to be a continuous one. Whereas here it is broken. Okay. This is the difference between bar graph and histogram. Okay, children. And today we are going to see about a new graph. Can you guess what it is going to be? We have seen bar graph, pie chart, histogram. What else? Very good. With the help of your textbook, you would have got an idea. Today we are going to see about line graph. Where have you seen this line graph? Do you have any idea about line graph? Surely it is going to deal with some lines. Are you able to recall the places where you have seen this line graph? Here, I have shown you a graph which has Delhi Daredevils and Kingstown Punjab. I believe everyone will watch cricket matches. Then they will compare run rate, batting rate, wickets between two teams or two players or even a single team. These graphs are called as line graphs. Okay, my dear children. So a line graph displays data that changes continuously over periods of time. It shows the continuous. As we have it in histogram, this is also going to deal with continuous data. Okay, my dear children. Now let us see how to interpret line graphs. Interpret. What does it mean by interpret? Getting information, getting conclusion from the graph. Words will not be there, passage will not be there. Just by looking at the graph, you should answer the following question. Shall we start, my dear children? Hope you people are ready with your graph note. This chapter, you will use graph note alone completely. Okay, my dear children. Shall we start? Okay, write chapter name, line graph, date, and use sharp pencils and scales. Okay, now the first question for you is, use the following line graph to answer the following question. Okay, this graph shows the yearly sales figures for a manufacturing company. It will be better, my dear children, if you have your text in your hand. Every time you will not be able to see the content in the slide I have provided, but then it is hidden under my camera. Okay, so have your textbook in your hand, my children. Are you able to see this graph in your book? Yes, it is from exercise 15.1. Chapter 15, exercise 15.1. Hope you all located this question. Here in a y-axis, sales in rupees crores. This 2 represents 2 crores. Okay, in years 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005 and 2006. Okay, now let us answer the question that comes up. What were the sales in 2002 and 2006? Hope you are going to answer me this question. Shall we check your answers are right? Dear children, now leave space for the questions alone. Just take down the answers. Later you can fill it up the question by copying it from your book. Okay. Drawings and questions can be done later. Now are you ready to answer that question? See here, in 2002, locate 2002 in x-axis. Now draw a straight line. No need to draw, just have a look. Use your scale to see where that line meets, that line graph meets. Here it meets at, in 2002, it meets at 4. So you will write the sale for the manufacturing company is 4. Am I right, my dear children? Similarly, for 2006, you will say it is 8. Hope you will write this 4 and 8. But I will not give you even a single mark if you write without units. So, your answer should be in proper sentence along with the units. What do that 4 represent? Look at the things that is there in the description of y-axis. It is sales in rupees crores. You should mention it as rupees 4 crore. Hope it is clear, my dear children. Now come on, write the next answer on your own. What were the sales in 2003, 2005? 2003, where does that line meet? The y-axis. It is somewhere between 6 and 8. You have to find it. Okay, got it? Similarly for 2005, have you located the answer? Hope you got the answer, but you will take some time to write the sentence. Now, let us check the answer. Very good, if you have done it right. Okay, these things are very simple. Right from class 5, you are doing this interpretation of data. The only difference is now you are doing it with line graph. Earlier, you did with bar graph, pie chart, histogram. Now, about line graph. Okay, my dear children, shall we move to the next question? The next question is, compute the difference between the sales in 2002 and 2006. What is the sale in 2002? Refer it and give me. Yes, it is 4 crore. Sale in 2006, rupees 8 crore. Now find the difference. What is meant by difference? You have to subtract it. So if you subtract, what difference will you get? Rupees 4 crore. Very good, my dear children. In which year was there the greatest difference between the sales as compared to its previous year? Now go back to this diagram. Here, from 2002 to 2003, how far it has changed? From 4 to 7. From 4 to 7. So what is the difference? Only 3. But if I say from 2004 to 2005, what is the difference? 4. So, from the previous year 2004, in 2005, it has changed a lot. So, I can answer that question as, was in the year 2005 as compared to previous year. Dear children, be careful with the questions. Okay, if it is going to compare with the next year, you should be able to compare it with the next year. Okay, this is how they will trick you in writing the answer. The next question is with two lines. Okay, the following graph shows the temperature forecast and the actual temperature. People used to forecast. Even in mobiles, you will be able to see whether it will rain today or not. We will have a forecast. But do you think it is happening every day and exactly the same time? No, sometimes it fails, sometimes it is not exact. So that is, they have stated a graph with two lines. This dotted line, just going along this dotted line, represent forecasts that they have predicted. That they have predicted that at this time, on Monday, you will have temperature 15. On Tuesday, you will have temperature 20. But what happened actually is given in continuous lines. Okay, their prediction on Monday is 15 temperature. But what happened on that day? It is between 15 and 20, 17.5. Okay, my dear children, now let us answer the questions. On which day was the forecast temperature the same as the actual temperature? So, you should find the points where both these lines intersect. Here, on Tuesday, then it doesn't match. Here too, it doesn't match. Then on Friday, it matches. And Saturday, it doesn't match. On Sunday, it matches. So, your answer is on Tuesday, Friday and Sunday. The next question is, what was the maximum forecast temperature during the year? Forecast temperature, my dear children. Forecast in the sense, you should follow the dotted lines. Maximum is on 35 degree. So, your answer will be 35 degree. Okay, my dear children, let us continue in the next video.